We've studied fire for a long time in Yellowstone. We've documented the incredible recovery of the forests of the 1988 fires. But what's happening now is the baselines are shifting, and basically, if you think about a game, the rules of the game are changing.
So just maybe cross over this meadow and then head into the right again?
Yeah.
I'm an ecologist because I worked in Yellowstone when I was 19 years old as a ranger at Old Faithful. So I saw it before the 1988 Yellowstone fires, and I have studied the fire since that time.
The fact that forests have regenerated after fire for thousands of years, and now they may not be, is important and is something that, as a society, we need to try to understand and then to think about if we're okay with that.
Those fires in 1988 really shepherded in a new era of fire activity in the West.
Behind me here, you can see the column of smoke from the North Fork Fire. Now, that's the fire that's threatening park headquarters. Also, another fire up on the park.
There was more extensive fire activity than I think most people had ever expected to see in one year at that time. And now we're starting to see the likelihood of fires reburning, you know, at much shorter intervals since the last fire, increasing through time here. And that's what we saw in 2016.
One of the most important things that when we think about how the forest will change in the future is their ability to recover. And so we call that resilience. And fundamental to that is the ability for a new forest to establish following disturbances.
This period of regeneration after fire is actually a really critical window where forests are vulnerable to transitioning to really different states than what they were before the fire.
The changes that are forecast are so different from what we had initially anticipated, even when we started considering the effects of climate change. As you translate that into what it means for the future of fire in Yellowstone, instead of having fires come back every 100 or 300 years, we would have the weather conditions pretty much all the time that would be associated with big fires. When the fires came through, we were interested in measuring what we call the severity of the fire, but what was the effect on the ecosystem? And we were testing a hypothesis that the severity could be quite high because you have all of the needles of the tree and all of the downed wood very close to each other. We would also be measuring the little baby tree seedlings. It's kind of a hide-and-seek game because you're looking for teeny tiny tree seedlings in a, you know, an area of blackened soil.
Most of the things that we would do for measuring burn severity on the trees are a little bit impossible to do when the trees are so severely burned that they're not here anymore.
It seems like fire is happening more frequently at a higher severity, burning a larger extent of the landscape. And so if that trajectory continues, what's that going to mean for forests? Is that going to mean that much of the forested landscape in Yellowstone is going to transition to a grassland or to an aspen parkland or to a sagebrush steppe environment? Or is the system even more resilient than we even thought it was and it's going to stay forested at least for another century or more?
When I think about Yellowstone and its potential for change, what I've always been struck by for all of the years I've been studying it is its potential to recover and its potential to be resilient to changes in ways that surprise us. I'm hopeful to see Yellowstone maintain its flora and its fauna and all of the beauty that is there. I'm optimistic that it will still do that, but I don't have any illusion that it will still always be the same. It will change.